funny. It was. I go to the academy. Adoko onyemi mei ona de mei do ametu na pen tuma me ago ndi patience Harriet Mavis ye fato no bia ne no ni o mbred mi table ni oba wo ame ni tuma metu ne e wale wa ame oba wo mi do ho ame wale magbene. Hey, Obi Ache, Napan 22. A turn up and two are going to Russia. Like a non detour. Bale Wale. Care, and it's one me. And it's one a fake. Care, Obi Acomo. Can a father me? It was bar. No, can not social. Hey, I've been a condi. Be a no, she'll be a no. Nigana. She went down a courtesy. Bafama, a cravata. Like a butiche. 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 Chafe, me and Chafe, ni oba wa. No do ya ne. Hani, no fara no ne amituwa. Ehi ame. Aminele, ehi ame. Ame sine me, gagbali ame. Ame biye, ame dwo sini wase, ame namuko ni anga mwanshi. Bede, kani bede ko tuto ame. Bwadumon sefle ni, ote yame. Out your feet. It don't be you. Meneme Meneswa, Nimaswa. Meneme Nimaswa, Namaswa. Oh. A quest. What I mean? What name men at on ye? Don't tell me a name at on ye. Don't ye me, left on ye. I'm a she be a day. When you meet you, Adoko. If after ye, ye had a two, ye had a two, ye had a two. Agwene, what you mean you? Am I say? Twist family. Twist book, Wiku. Oh, and now. And am I me? I'm a bee. Oh, na kore paye konu. Nai paye konu. Oh, sakubo paye konu. Eh. Oh, njo. Minchebo ekonu. Buga bibi ojibi. Dem. Stand up for sa. Eh. Nye yo adoko. No yade. No no na. No, pet or are you? I want the name. Well, that I see. We are true. I talk pet or no baby, eh? I talk pet or no baby, eh? Never know, can I go down, eh? Never know, can I go down? Oh, near you. Get there. Okay, when she did not be she. Oh, let everybody into your harm. What's that? Number don't. She bought one of me, eh? Obanam. Agwene, when you are me, G, a person, you are be a dog, eh? Gertrude, Linda, Lizzie, Tio, McCabe. Okay, oh, I want to bar. I don't go. Yawa to bar. Yawa to bar. Oh, and then Bio. Mintole, bad you know. Twa, my yaba. Twa.
When you meet you, it's in the town of Kemi, it's more than local after. She could soon I war. Tell me again, me. Tell me. Minute to one year. One quack fight. If I had a grand one. On your grand one. If I had a grand one. Twelve, my yabba.
Sorry, I guess. No.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
Thank you. Yeah, I wanna. need a bossana dia. In Kenya wala.
Come on, come on.
You chemola la wale. Me you chemola la posale. Wabala. Wabala. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Oh, hang on, Kedjewin, He is enthroned tonight. He is so uncommon in excellence in qualities. Oh, perfection and flawless. That's our God. Lift up your hands, everyone. We lift our hands. Oh, my God. And voice. In breath and spirit and tonight, oh, he loves to hear your voice and give to God praise.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. In waters of baptism, Florence died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. In life, Florence cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet her with his words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Florence received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. Let us pray. Almighty God and the Father, this is our certain prayer, that of your Son who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruit of all who had fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Florence, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. Beyond this, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Now I invite the person to read the first reading. Now I invite Ms. Harris Sawa to read the first reading from that lecture.
The first reading is taken from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 3, verses 1 to 9. The source of the virtues are the hands of God. No demon shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster, their living as like annihilation, but they are not at peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight with their affliction, great with their blessing be. God has put them to the test and proved them to be worthy to be with him. He has tested them like a gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out. As sparks run through the stubble, so they will. They shall judge nations, rule over people, and the Lord will be their king forever. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love, for grace and mercy await those he has chosen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Your response. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. Your response. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these, you give me comfort. Your response. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Your response. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Your response? The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Please stand. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest, says the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. I read from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have not told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after which I have gone, and I will prepare a place for you, and I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, maybe too you are." "You know the way to the place where I am going," Thomas said. "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, life is a journey from home to doom. The greatest journey in the Old Testament was a journey from Egypt to your promised land. For us, our promised land is not on this earth. Our promised land, where milk and honey flows, is in heaven with the Lord. The journey to the promised land in the Old Testament is a symbol of journey that each of us make to God as we go through this life. Between our birth and death, we are pilgrims in the road to God. How well we live and love makes the difference. Here lies Florence, and we all miss her, and we believe and we are here to pray for her. Jesus, even in his lifetime, he wept for Lazarus, a God who knows about the resurrection, who knows about the life after death. Even he could not, understand the separation that he had to undergo for his friend Lazarus. The Lord who cried knows the pain that we carry today, the missing feeling that we have, the vacuum that we feel because of the loss of Florence. Yet we always believe that she is in a better place now with the Lord, as Jesus has promised us today in the Gospel. "I'm going to prepare a place for you." We believe Jesus has prepared a place for Florence, and we also believe that our Florence is not merely disappearing from this world, but she gives us an assurance that she is going to be a guardian angel to us. She will guide us. The people who miss and who pray to the Lord, she will be a vessel to carry and intercede for our prayer. We feel that she is near to God to intercede for our cause. And definitely, God, with his abundant blessing and Mother Mary's intercessions, we will be guided. So with that trust, we are here. And I also invite you, as the friends, the children, and the partner, and all of you are here. And you are here not just for the sake of being family together, but you are here to pray for her soul. This recurring Mass is precisely
to pray for the repose of the soul of Florence, so that even if she has committed any sins in the world, that will be forgiven, and let her journey to God become very smooth, and let her see God face to face. But this, let us all close our eyes and pray for Florence for a while. Loving Father, we surrender before you, Florence. Let her soul be rested in your peace. I also surrender before you her children, grandchildren, and all the relatives who are here on her behalf. Console them. Give them courage and strength to bear these loss. We also surrender to you, especially the people who cannot accept this loss. Let your mother Mary be on their side to intercede for them. Loving Father, we make all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the mind and work of human hands. It will become for us the spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Please stand. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hand for the grace and the glory of his name, for the goodness of the Holy Spirit. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Florence, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt her son to be the loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sin, we are redeemed to Christ a great victory, with him called back into life. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel down, those who can. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. May holy death He took bread, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Lord, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in death by peace, may also be with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be poised eternal life and may Christ in glory for you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace nowadays, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who sit your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be translated into my room, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us all for eternal life. Thank you.
Biography of Madam Florence Mavis Adorkor Acquaye. The late Madam Florence Mavis Adorkor Acquaye was born on Monday, the 23rd of June, 1958, to the late Mr. Charles C. Acquaye, who hailed from Accra. Her mother was the late Madam Evelyn Korantima Ado of Osu and Akropong in the Eastern Region. Mavis was the eighth child of her parents. At the age of six, she started her primary and elementary education at the South La Estates and eventually completed and passed the final examination with distinction. She later got admission at King's College. After successfully completing her education at King's College, she was employed at Accra City Council, now renamed as the Accra Metropolitan Assembly, and later on got an appointment to work at the government secretariat. In order to broaden her horizon, Mavis left the shores of Accra in March 1984 to the United Kingdom, the country she spent the rest of her life until her painful and untimely demise. Mavis did work for several companies during the early part of her stay in the UK. However, she made a decision to devote her energy and time to take care of her two children, considering the difficulties that was prevalent with childcare. Mavis, during the period of 2000 to 2002, undertook a medical receptionist and teaching assistant courses at Southwark College. Her decision to prioritize the onerous task of having to virtually have an hands-on approach to bringing up her children under such difficult circumstances has been vindicated for all the world to see. Her children, Stanley and Crystal, who she has sadly left behind, have achieved the educational laurels she had been dreaming of and are now in gainful employment. Her devotion to such a task has not been in vain. Yes, God is good all time, and may his name be praised in the highest. Mavis, our dear sister, was very kind-hearted and was always willing to offer her help whenever the occasion demanded. She stood firmly by her siblings and played a motherly role to them. The entire family has lost a dear one, and her children, siblings, nephews, nieces, and the entire family are saddened and devastated. But then we are consoled in the knowledge by that the Almighty knows best, and therefore we have to accept her demise as God's will. Mavis was a devout Christian and served the Lord with all her might and heart. May the good Lord keep you till we meet again, Mavis. Rest well, Mavis. Mavis, yawo juba. Anyemi papa, nye papa, yawo juba.
I'm reading this tribute on behalf of the siblings back home in Ghana. In Romans chapter 14, verses 7 to 8, the Bible says that we do not live to ourselves and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. It is with heavy hearts filled with pain that we pay this tribute to our dear sister, who we affectionately called Sister Mavis. The death of our Sister Mavis came as a shock to us. In fact, we became so devastated and could not come to terms with the situation in which we found ourselves. However, it is the God Almighty who has been able to soothe our emotions at this present moment. Whilst you were alive, our dear sister Mavis, you always reminded us that in everything we should thank the Lord. Who are we therefore to challenge that assertion? God has spoken, and who are we as mere mortals to question his decision? For he knows best, and he has done his will. Rest in perfect peace. Mavis, Yahweh Jehovah.
Thank you, Lisa. Now I invite Stanley to do the science tribute.
As you know, my name is Stanley Nido Dudoki. I'm the first son of Florence Mavis Adorkor. It's an honor to tell you how exceptional and lucky I was to call this woman my mother. Florence Mavis Adorkor was born to my grandma and my grandfather, Charles and Evelyn Adorkor. Most people know that my mother grew up in Accra. She acquired a taste for wache and sardines and shito when she used to go to school. When she used to finish school with her friends. She always used to talk to me about it. My mother enjoyed taking the bus and traveling around Accra with her siblings. She would later take me and my sister around West London, showing us around Park Lane, Oxford Circus, and we'd just sit on the bus all day. While I was attending secondary school, I wanted a pair of shoes that would look good in my school uniform. Me and my mum went to the store to see that the price of the shoes was out of our budget. And I remember looking at the people that could afford the shoes and their jackets. And I was thinking I wanted them. But when I met them, they wasn't the nicest people. And I remembered what my mother told me when I was leaving the store, that money wasn't everything. And some things you just have to learn the hard ways. I didn't realize how kind and friendly my mother was, and the ability to break the ice and just speak with people and just make them feel comfortable. I think it's just a really good gift, gift that I wish I had. My mother always used to just always be there for other people, especially when there was funerals. She would wake up early in the morning, make kenke and chofi, and she would leave me just a little bit with some black pepper. And she'll say, and I'll say, do you even know these people? And she said, when it's my turn, they will help you. Now that it's our turn, I fully understand. Thank you. As time has gone on, I can see how the death can affect. I can see how death can affect yourself, your loved ones, and the people around them. She just said, I can see how the death around other people can change you, and you see other people for who they are. I'm very fortunate to see who everyone cared about my mother, who came to see my mom, who gathered the clothes, who just helped with everything, making food for us. Really do appreciate you for all coming. Thank you so much. My mum never had a glorious career, but she was very bright. Her friends used to call her Brain Box, but I was like, why would they call you Brain Box? But it was only later when I learned how to drive and I was driving around London, my sat nav would die and I don't know where I'm going. But she'll be able to tell me exactly how to get home, how to get to the party. And I said, how do you know this? You had never even driven before. And she says, yeah, that's why my friends call me Brain Box. But there was one time she did lead me astray and was in a Liverpool Street area. And then she said, Stanley, take this way, it's a shortcut. And I said, Mum, are you sure? There's something else that I should go around. She said, JJ, and she said, go down the road. As I went down the road, I realized that it was bus only, and I told her, "Mom, you've just taken me down the wrong way." And then she said, "Oh, sorry, my teacher died young." And I said, "Thank you." I was very lucky not to be a fire. Both Crystal and I are so pleased to see many of you are here to understand what special person my mum was. We're grateful that you've joined us to honour and celebrate her life, a life lived with a lot of partying involved and meeting good people. She proved that you don't need to pursue a career to have a loving impact on the people around you. Let's carry her legacy by making the people around us feel comfortable and happy, and by her being with us anywhere we go. Thank you so much for coming, and may God be with all of you. Amen.
Thank you, Stanley. Now I invite Crystal to do your interview.
Thank you to you all for coming here to celebrate the life of my mum, Florence. It's unfortunate that we are all gathered here today under these circumstances. I just have a few words to say about my mum, and I've written it in a letter. Dear mum, I can't believe I had to write this as early on in my life as I thought, but I guess we're here now. Since you left us, I have been strong and resilient, as you have taught me. I haven't said much, nor have I cried much. But here's my chance to express myself to you, so I hope you're watching over us, listening. Mummy, you were my best friend, my gisting partner, and my twin, as I look just like you. I don't even know where to start to talk about your personality. You were always so happy, and you always saw the positives in everything. You were kind-hearted and helped people, even if it was small. You were so funny, and you were always the life of the party. You were a great cook and the best with making kenke and coffee. You were so smart, and you had so many dreams. This is even a small fraction of your personality. You helped me so much in my life to this point, from taking care of me when I was sick, making me laugh whenever I was upset, and lastly, providing the most encouragement throughout my studies and my personal problems. You sacrificed so much just to get me to this point. You once sent me a WhatsApp message that said, "A mum is a small portion of God's love in action." You proved this statement to be true, as no matter what we went through, and no matter how much we argued, you always showed me your unconditional love, and you would always make up no matter what. You taught me to be positive in all things, and to never cry. When I found out that you had cancer, I cried for 3 days. You told me to stop crying and to keep positive, as God was going to heal you. You never even cried once, and you sat there and you dealt with the pain. Even as you were getting sicker, you continuously prayed and kept your faith in God. You really showed me your strength as a woman to carry such a burden. You didn't even want any help. You just wanted to come out of it strong and healthy. And this is why you never told anyone. I just hope to be half the woman that you were. Mummy. I tried my best to take care of you, I promise. And I know that you knew that. I did my best. Even as you died in my arms, I knew that you did. I sit down sometimes and I think of the 31st. Think of how the day panned out. I think of what I would have done differently. I wish I took you to the hospital sooner. I wish the CPR that I did would have saved you. I blame myself. I blame the doctors that diagnosed you. What God called you, there was nothing that I could have done. That night, I sat down, and I just remembered that you used to tell me that you would pass away on a monumental day, and it just happened to be the last day of 2020. The hardest thing for me is knowing that you won't be here to see me get married, or have kids, but I have peace knowing that you saw my future child in your dreams. You told me the morning that you died. You even named him. You told me in your dream that you carried him and he called you grandma. I wanted it to be different. I didn't want the same thing you had as not having your mother around, but unfortunately, this is the reality. I have kept strong this far, and I will continue to. I will continue to make you proud, and I will be a success for you. I love you, Mom. I will forever love you. You are the world to me. I pray that you rest in absolute perfect peace and tranquility. That is what you deserve. Until we meet again, love from your princess.
Florence. Thank you. getting ready to go to the cemetery now, so stay tuned.
Oh, every morning. His love is new every morning. He gives us day by day our daily bread. And every day of our lives, we've got something new to say about Jesus. Because he never appears the same way all the time. Hallelujah. And it's so great when you know him. And it's so great to know a man that will be with you anytime, through any kind of problems. All you have to do is just call on him. And he's right there.
Oh. Oh, Not the right one, not the right one.